It's the Daily Doug.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Daily Doug. Thanks for hanging out with me today for another song reaction and breakdown. You will notice that I am in our new space. It is yet unfinished. There's nothing on the walls yet, but we do have curtains now, so we're getting somewhere. We're not fully operational yet, but we're operational enough to listen to some tunes and share some music and have a good old time. So I am glad you're here. I was trying to figure out which song to include on today's episode, and I was looking through the list, and I'm like, I haven't done Tool in a long time, so we're going to rectify that right now. The song we're going to do today is called Right In Two, and this song by Tool is from their album 10,000 Days. And this was their fourth studio album, released in 2006. It's celebrating its 15th anniversary this year. And in fact, this would be their last album for more than a decade. They didn't release Fear Inoculum until 2019. So I am curious to give this one a shot. It is the next to last track on the album. And as I've been looking at the lyrics, their point of view in this is really interesting. I'm very eager to see what the musical setting sounds like to accompany this really powerful poem. So let's waste no more time. This is Tool, Right In Two. Here we go. We're listening to the studio version of this. Boy, they have a really distinct sound, don't they? So it's either 11 or it's a measure of 6 plus a measure of 5. So unique. I love this band. So we got D minor, E flat, G minor, C, D. I think those four chords are just kind of circling around. So it's something new now. Still in that 11 kind of groove. Metal things that they're hitting on, the sound of all the percussion stuff, it's really fascinating. Father blessed them all a reason, and this is what they choose. Monkey killing, monkey killing, monkey, pieces of the ground. Monkey killing, monkey killing over pieces of the ground. They forge a blade, and where there's one, they're bound to divide it right in two. This song is from the point of view of angels. It starts off with them saying, angels on the sideline, puzzled and amused. Right? Why did Father give these humans free will? Now they're all confused. Woo! D major for a second. Pieces of the ground. They kill each other over pieces of the ground. Still in that 6 plus 5 rhythm. Guided as a mystery. major for a fleeting second, back to minor. Wow, that lyric is powerful, y'all. Change things up for that little what sounds like a chorus, maybe. Cut it and divide it all right in two. That lyric that I said was really powerful was repugnant is a creature who would squander the ability to lift an eye to heaven, conscious of his fleeting time here. Amazing. Amazing. So is this. Those sound like tabla drums, hand drums, like Indian tabla drums, not Native American, Indian. Awesome. It's so tasteful. Stayed in that meter the entire time. that's a fascinating and eclectic arrangement of sounds. So unique. What a surprise that was. Y'all, I really dug that. Did you like that? I thought it was great. Harmonically, there is not much range in that song, but I've never gotten that Tool was about giving us complex harmonies just for the sake of giving us complex harmonies. They have something that they want to say, and they're a rhythmic-driven band, right? They often play in D minor, and that's what this one was in. Angels on the Sideline again. Been so long with patience and reason. Wondering when this tug of war will end. It's the point of view from the angel's perspective is a unique take on this. It's like we might be able to get into a standpoint of what might God think of how humans are acting. But what about all of the angels that are like on the sidelines going, why did he do that? Why did he give these humans free will? And now they're all confused, right? So this is, they say, plenty in this holy garden, silly old monkeys. Where's the one you're bound to divide it right in two? It reminds me, sorry to make this leap, but it reminds me of the ending, spoiler alert, of the musical Hamilton. The line towards the end, the lesson of everything included in the lyrics at the end of that musical is the world was wide enough, right? We don't have to fight over resources. Just because one might have a resource or a job or an opportunity does not mean that that opportunity was specifically taken away from another person. There is enough opportunity, enough resources, enough knowledge, enough space for everyone if we all share and live and commit to living in this society communally, right? It's not me, it's us. And then it's not us versus them, it's just us, right? It's something that we're still struggling with, don't you think? But boy, I really enjoyed that bit. There's some, it's almost Buddhist a little bit in its construction, which is, I think, might be where those tabla drums came in. The whole mixing of this and mastering and arrangement of this song, allowing this much space in the mix for these really interesting little percussive elements, some metallic, some just regular drumming, was really, really cool to hear. Great stuff. I will try to get my office set up so that we're fully operational, but in the meantime, I'm happy to be giving these videos and taking a little bit of time out of the day where we're still trying to actually finish moving in and listen to some music and share that with all of you. Glad you were here. Thanks for being with us today, and we will see you next time for another edition of the Daily Dug.